how to organize plugins. So I've done some of these, I answered some of these questions in the past, but again, this question comes up because it's a good question and some people do not know how to organize plugins in FL Studio. And I think it's a really cool thing to know, because when you are adding plugins to your library or to FL Studio or to any other DAW, sometimes FL Studio might give you some random place where they put the plugins. So I like to always organize my plugins so that I have them in a specific order. And let's go and let me show you how to do that. So the first thing that you do is to, let's do here in the channel rack. Let me show you. As you can see, my plugins are organized in this fashion. So I like to have it in this tree view. And to change this, you just go here to categories, simple or tree. And by doing that, so let's see categories. And now it shows up a big list. I like to have that in categories. Even when you do here categories, you have third parties, Air, Arturia, and so on. So all the folders that I did, now they are selected in that way. If you do simple, you will have organized by alphabetic order, but I like to have a tree because it's a little bit easier for me. I know already where to go and it's very easy for me to go to places that I like. I like this type of menu. So how does one organize these plugins? So as you can see, I have SonyVox folder with a bunch of plugins. I have third party, and here I have a bunch of other plugins here. I have waves. So how can you create these own folders so that you have a tree structure like this? It's very simple. You go here to the browser, and if we go to the plugin database, we have effect, generator, and installed. If I go here, for instance, to installed, we have effects and generators. If I open these ones, you see that we have Fruity, New, VST, and VST3. Most of the times, this will be just for FL Studio plugins. And this one here, VST and VST3, will be for FL Studio plugins. So if I open here, or if I click here, you see that first I'm in effects. So there's two distinctions, effects and generators. Effects are the plugins that you use here to generate, generators are the plugins that you use here in the channel rack to load instruments and play sounds. And then if you go to the mixer, then you will have here the effects. And these are different type of plugins compared to the generators. So generators are plugins that create sound, effects are plugins that effect sound, or they apply some type of effect. This could be filters, distortion, reverb, delay, stuff like that. So now let's go and go here to generators. And if I do VST, you see that I have a big list of plugins here. If I go to generators, this is where I have all the organization that you can see here whenever I do have here. So if you see here, third party, and I have this folder here, third party, and then I have the air folder there, and so on. To do that, you right click here and you do open. If you do open, you will open up a folder in your Windows Explorer. And this is where you can create your or organize the plugins the way you want. And you can create folders, you can do folders inside folders, and so on. One plugin that I installed recently is this sample tank here. And I want to move this plugin into my third-party library. So let me move this aside just a little bit. As you can see, I have the plugin here directly as in sample tank 4. If I go back to the database here with generators, you see that I have the sample pack, sample tank 4 here. So let's do Control X and let's move this to the third party, and let's do Control V. Very simple. If I update this, now I have sample tank 2, 3, and 4. And if I go back to the FL Studio, let me do that. And if I do refresh here the browser, you see that the sample tank 4 disappeared from here. And if I open up this one, it's also disappeared from there. So if I now go to third party, you see that sample tank is here. So this is the way you do this. It's very simple. You just drag and drop stuff, you create folders, and you can organize everything as you want. You can also change the original plugins from image line. So let's say you have here the synth classic. Let's say you want to bring these ones into synth and have just one folder with all the synths that you have. You could do something like that. Just organize these as you would organize any file in your system. And this, you can, as you can see, this is a FL Studio preset. So this is not changing the DLL per se. So this is not changing the plugin location. This is just a reference file that helps you to organize here the list. So if you delete, for instance, if I delete sample tank 4 from this folder, it will not delete sample tank plugin itself from your system. It will only delete the reference in here, in this menu. You can always add this reference with more plugins, but it will not, it's a distinction that I have to make. It will not remove your plugin from your system. It just removes the reference inside FL Studio. So that's an important thing. So you can move this around as you want without any issues of removing your plugins from your system.